गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
आर यू हियरिंग माय वॉइस?
यस सर।
ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू टुडेज कॉन्सेप्ट आई हैव टू ओके सो राइट सो बिफोर गोइंग टू टुडेज कॉन्सेप्ट द साइंटिफिकल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ रोमन सिविलाइजेशन वी हैव टू सी द थिंग्स व्हाट वी डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास कैन यू गिव मी वन आर टू पॉइंट्स व्हाट वी डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट क्लास What concepts we discussed in the last class?
Roman art and architecture.
Okay.
Romans were mostly influenced by Greek art and architecture.
Right.
Some.
Okay. Okay. Pratibha, others, can you give me one or two points?
Sorry about art and architecture. About ancient Roman art, the Colosseum,
right?
And the important points about Colosseum.
Yeah, right. So in the last class, we had a discussion over the ancient Roman art and architecture. As a part of art and architecture, they constructed certain buildings. Like this insale, which is one of the a apartment like structure for the poor people, and rich and the rich are any landlords. They followed certain a big building structures called as the villas, and these villas apart from their own. Houses or homes at various cities and towns. They also maintain certain villas at the countryside, where their lands are there. And in between those lands, they constructed these villas like a farmhouses or like. Okay, so apart from these, there are certain common buildings and public buildings also. We'll see in the. History of ancient Rome, like the Forum, which is a marketplace, or the public place where the people, like the intellectual class, or any leader, or the leaders, particularly in the society, can have a speeches in front of the public, or like that. Okay, so apart from these. There are other public buildings like constructions of these Colosseum, like amphitheater. Okay, so which is like a open air theater where nearly 50,000 people can sit and watch certain shows like gladiator shows are like that. Okay, so apart from there are other royal buildings also there and. A temple like structures like the Pantheon are the one of the important public building where we see in the architecture of ancient Rome and as a part of this ancient architecture of Roman civilization they had certain imitation or the inspiration from the Greek basically Okay, so they are copied certain things from the Greek civilization, and they are copied only the columns. Okay, so columns are certain pillar-like structure with the white white color, and these pillars also they maintain certain capital. Okay, so and they also followed certain base at the bottom and capital at the top also. Okay, so every building has a certain columns, a pillars, which is a important structure they copied from the ancient Greece. And apart from these columns, they also followed the arch and dome structure. It's purely a the Roman phenomena, Roman contribution. Okay, so and one more thing in the architecture of ancient Rome was the first and foremost people who used the concrete. Okay, so concrete, which is a creation of these Roman people while constructing the various buildings also. Okay, so apart from this, they also constructed certain beautiful structures at the public places like the fountains or goat fish ponds. Okay, so apart from these, they also followed the aqueducts. Okay, so the aqueducts are the water channels which are carrying from the outside of various city. Okay, so like a reservoir or any lake outside the city, from that they can construct certain aqueducts to the city or within the city to supply of these water. Okay, so all these things we discussed in the last class. And apart from these, we have a detailed discussion over the Colosseum, where we see in the Rome, city Rome. Okay, so the Colosseum, which is a largest public building, where we can have this have a open place where nearly 50,000 people they can watch, which is constructed around 80 AD or like that, and which is nearly the 5 to 6 stories height, and they can they use these Colosseums for particularly certain shows of gladiator shows, and sometimes these places can use for killing of these slaying of slaves by the hungry lions. Okay, which is also a great amusement which the Roman people has borrowed. And apart from this, they also enjoyed with certain chariot and horse races also. Okay, so and these them had a structure of the modern theaters, like these are a gradual slope we'll see, and in front seats they reserved for the high status people like the senators or for the consuls or like that. Okay, so and next row, which is for the high class people. Okay, so the people from the higher strata, particularly from the patrician class, are like that. Okay, so the last row is confined to the common people. Okay, so these colosseums also have certain separate box for watching these shows for particularly the emperors or royal families. Okay, so constructions they followed. Okay, so apart from that, we also see a certain public bath systems where they followed in the in certain occasions like the festivals are like that. Okay, so during the Saturnalia they can use these public bath system also. Okay, so these are the things we discussed in the last class, and today we are going to see certain scientific contribution. And within the scientific contribution, we will start with the science first of all. Okay, so before going to my explanation, I have to share my screen, and then I will continue my lecture. Okay, students, are you getting my screen?
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
sir.
Yes, history of Roman medicine. The herbal medicine is common in every civilization. Okay, so here the Romans particularly maintain certain personal cleanliness, and for the hygiene, they built certain the big baths are like that. Okay, so all the towns and cities could boast of a good drainage system. Okay, so in the last class also we discussed about this sewerage and hygienic conditions, and to maintain all these, they followed certain a planned drainage system or like that. Okay, so and as a part of this medicine, they built hospitals where the patients were treated by a qualified physicians and given medicines. And the greatest physician of this period was the Galen. Okay, so Galen was the greatest physician during the ancient Roman period. Okay, so he wrote a number of books, nearly more than 500 books are like that on human anatomy and physiology, and where he explained the functions of different organs of human body. Okay, so Galen, which explained about human body also. Okay, so apart from him, there are other important doctors we will see in the ancient Roman civilization, like one of the Greek doctors in the particular became very well known throughout the Rome was Asclepiades. Okay, so would not accept the Hippocrates ideas about the four humors and claiming that the body was made up of tiny atoms that always moving around the body. Okay, so Hippocrates also another important personality who also a initiator of the medicine, basically the things of the medicine in the Roman civilization. Okay, so and they followed certain tools, medicinal tools. The Romans made advance in the surgery, and mainly because it fixed their practical needs also. Okay, so the Roman Empire was based on conquering land with their highly effective army. So getting their injured soldiers of fighting was the goal. Okay, so whenever they participated in the war or battles, the soldiers may injured, and they can lost certain body parts like hand or leg or like that. Okay, so at that time, these physicians or surgeons, they followed certain a form of surgeon using certain tools to attach those cut legs or hands. Okay, so and this is one of the what you are watching on the screen. Okay, so such a saw they used for these cutting these bones or any other parts of the body whenever they get injured. Okay, and sometimes they use in this as in the part of surgery also. Okay, so another important tools we are you are watching on the screen is like a scalpel. Okay, so a scalpel for slicing open flesh. Okay, these are the small knives they used in the surgery are like that. Okay, so and apart from that, another one is the probe. Before any surgery, this probe were used to explore the wound. Okay, so whenever any small wound taken place or any fracture has taken place, they can first of all they can clean with this probe also. Okay, so apart from that, another one is the catheters. Okay, so the catheters were used to drain the bladder of the patients who were having difficulty going to the loo. Okay, so which is also another important a technique they followed. And next one is Asclepius. Okay, so Asclepius is the Greek god of healing and was the only the Greek gods the Romans prayed to. His symbol is twin snakes winding around the staff. Okay, so which is a symbol for medicine. Okay, so whenever you see there are many other important things you'll find in the Roman medicine. And for the Roman medicine, they followed certain sources also. Among them, which is a Pliny's Natural Historia, a large book or a work of all known the science. Another one is the Ptolemy, who wrote Almagest, a gist of astronomical account at that age. Okay, so apart from medicine, they had important works on this astronomy also. Okay, so and apart from this, they also followed certain important things like the astronomical units, where they made the first world calendar by calculating everything in the universe. Okay, so the Julian calendar was prepared by Sosigenes, an astronomer of Alexandria, who calculated the base years as a 365.25 days. It was introduced in 45 BC by the Julius Caesar. Okay, so while discussing about the Julius Caesar, we had the discussion over this Julian calendar. Okay, so Julian calendar, still we are following as a world time on the basis of this Julian calendar. Okay, so and apart from this, I have to give you the other things like the engineering skills and how they followed the engineering skills and how they used the concrete, which is a great contribution of these Romans. Okay, so a massive system of aqueducts also they follow. Okay, so I will give you these things I will share my screen and then explain. Okay, so this is how they followed this engineering skills. First of all, I will give you the Romans were excellent engineers and the builders, and many of the buildings and the engineering projects they design are still around today, and some are still being used. Okay, so here are some of the things about these engineering skills of the Romans. Okay, so they were the important people who followed or who constructed certain roads. Okay, so during the time of Augustus, we'll see nearly 374 roads which well connected with the city of Rome. Okay, so every province and every trade center in the Roman civilization which well connected with the Rome. Okay, so that's why there is a ancient saying which is all roads leads to the Rome, right? So during the Augustus time, this had taken place, and later emperors were which developed all those things, and with these very these roads are helpful for moving from one place to another very easily, and supplying these goods and raw materials from one place to another very easily, and they saved much time also. Okay, so the Roman roads were important to the economy and the military of the Roman, and they allowed for easier commerce between the towns and cities, and also allowed the Roman legions to move quickly around the expanding the empire. And the roads were designed to last despite the environment, and they were built using many layers of machinery, including the concrete. And these durable roads are still which use in the world today also. Okay, so there were also built with the hump, making water flow to the edges, and this kept the roads from the flooding and allowed them to be used in rainy weather also. Okay, so and we already have a discussion over the Colosseum yesterday, and we'll see once again, right? The Colosseum in the Rome is a great example of Roman engineering and the construction, and the Colosseum was a large outdoor stadium that could seat around 50,000 people for various forms of entertainment, such as the gladiator games and mock battles and dramas also. The huge Colosseum is freestanding and built with multiple arches to give it strength also. Okay, so much of it, it still stands, much of the part of this Colosseum, it still stands today. And although earthquakes have knocked a portion of it down, and it is 615 feet long and 510 feet wide, and took around 131,000 cubic yards of the stone to make it. Okay, so which is a large or a huge public place where many things happen in those theaters or open air theaters. Okay, so another one is another engineering skill of the Roman Empire or the Roman people was the construction of aqueducts. Okay, so aqueduct were long channels that Romans built to carry water into the cities. Many of the Roman aqueducts were below the ground. Okay, so the water that was carried into the cities was used for drinking water, baths, and showers. Okay, so it was generally carried to a public fountain where people could then use the bucket type structures to get their water also. Okay, so Roman plumbing became so advanced that many of the large wealthy houses had running water also. Okay, so you are watching the Roman aqueduct, which is like a modern bridges where they separately constructed the carrying the water pipeline through various water bodies on the rivers or canals are like that. In the modern days, you find such a bridges where these water pipelines can carry. Okay, so such a modern technique which followed during the time of the Roman civilization, ancient Roman period. Okay, so another one is construction of the bridges also. And the Romans built long durable bridges. Many of their bridges still stand today. And they use stone and concrete to build their bridges and use the arch as the basic architectural feature to make them strong also. Okay, so the best Roman bridge ever built was the Trajan Bridge over the river Danube. It was over 3,700 feet long and 62 feet high. Okay, so first of all, the concrete bridge, construction of concrete bridge is a great contribution of the Roman Empire. Okay, so construction of bridges are, we have certain things we already discussed in certain other civilizations also. Okay, so in the Babylonian, during the time of Nebuchadnezzar, we have a bridge in between the two banks of the river in the Babylonia, but it's not built with this concrete or like that, but this Trojan bridge, which is constructed in the ancient Rome, Roman civilization was, which is purely constructed with the concrete. Okay, so the Roman engineering had a large influence on the Roman architecture, and arches were used a lot due to their strength. The Romans also used domes as the enabled them to build large ceilings with wide open spaces also. Okay, so here we have certain facts also. The Romans built over 4 lakh kilometer of the roads, including 29 highways that lead to the city of the Rome. And the Latin word road is via. We already discussed. Okay, so the plural of via is way. Okay, so Roman roads generally had the name via in them, like the via Appia and the via Flaminia, also important highways which they followed in the Roman civilization. And all the aqueducts in the city of Rome together totaled around 5 miles in length. Okay, so these aqueducts which carrying water to the city Rome, which is a huge city, which capacity of more than 1 million people, which is a crowded population you see in the ancient part, particularly in the Rome. Okay, so that that much crowded population can get water through these aqueducts, which is nearly this having the 500 millions of length pipeline they constructed at the time. Okay, so and the Romans were among the first civilizations to harness water power also. Okay, so it is estimated that Romans built over 900 bridges in all over the Roman Empire. Okay, so such a great contribution we can get from the Roman civilization. Okay, so apart from these, we had other important things as a part of the mathematics and reason, like the Roman numericals, which are the important things where we have we have to glance over it. Okay, so you are already aware that certain Roman numericals are a great contribution of the Roman civilization. Okay, so still we are using such numericals in our daily life also. Okay, so and apart from these certain basic things of mathematics, they followed like the multiplication, addition, subtraction also. Okay, so the Roman numericals, which is were used by the ancient Romans as the numbering system. Okay, so we still use them sometimes today, and these can see the Super Bowl's numbering system. Okay, so after king's name, the king Henry IV, which is Henry IV is a medieval, later medieval king. Okay, so before that also they use certain numbers also. Okay, so the numericals are base of 10 or the decimal, like the numbers we use today, and they are not entirely positional. However, there is no number zero. Okay, so the Roman numericals use letters instead of the numbers you are watching on the screen. Okay, so which is one, which is I equal to 1, and V which is equal to 5, and X equal to 10, L equal to 50, C equal to 100, and D equal to 500, and M equal to 1000. Okay, such numbers you are already aware about it, and we can have certain things over it, and which is these are certain numbers we are still following in our daily life. Okay, so and these are also a great contribution from the ancient Romans. Okay, so apart from that, there are many other important things we can learn from this Roman civilization. Okay, so those are you can get certain concepts in the mathematical in the subject of mathematics, like polygons and quadrilaterals, triangles and Pythagorean theorem, and circle, perimeter, surface area. Okay, so and basic laws of mass and primary numbers, decimals. Okay, so all these are certain fractions, right? So, and all these are great contributions of these ratios and mean, median. Okay, so all these are great contribution of this ancient Roman civilization itself. Okay, so this is certain things about the Roman civilization. And apart from these, there are other the things they followed, like the sanitation. Sanitation in the sense they used a good drainage system, where the drainage system, which is the domestic drainage system, which is connected with the public drainage system, where the drains are constructed both sides of the roads, and the same drainage which is connected to the outside of the city, where all the wastewater can leave the town and the cities at that time. Okay, so, and these we also had yesterday about the public bath system, which is with the name of the Therme, which is also another important contribution from these ancient Romans. Okay, so dear students, all these are certain scientific contributions of ancient Romans, and this is end of my class today. And regarding this Roman civilization and the contribution of Roman civilization, scientific contribution of Roman civilization, have any doubts or clarification, you can ask me now. This is end of this Roman civilization, and we'll see from tomorrow onwards from this Indus Valley civilization once again. Okay, so I'll be give you certain things what we left earlier. I will cover all those things from the Indus Valley and the Chinese civilization and Mesopotamia and Egypt and Greek and Roman. Okay, so Roman already we covered everything, but in other civilizations we left certain things, I think. Okay, so I will complete those things also in the future or the further classes. Okay, so students, this is end of my class. Can you have any doubts regarding this class or before classes or regarding assignment? Or now you can welcome to ask. అసైన్మెంట్స్ రాస్తున్నారా? వన్ ఆర్ టూ మెంబర్స్ పంపించినట్టు ఉన్నారు అసైన్మెంట్స్.
సో మిగతా
యా అసైన్మెంట్స్ కూడా రాసే ప్రయత్నం చేయండి. ఆల్రెడీ కొంత మెటీరియల్ పోస్ట్ చేస్తున్నాను మీకు గ్రూప్లలో. సో అవి మీరు ఎలాగైనా యూజ్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. అంటే అవి మీరు అసైన్మెంట్ రాయటానికి లేదా ఎగ్జామినేషన్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో చదువుకోవడానికి అండ్ కాంపిటేటివ్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్స్ కూడా మీకు ఉపయోగపడే విధంగా కొన్ని ఏదైతే ఎన్సీఆర్టీకి సంబంధించినటువంటి ఏదైతే మెటీరియల్ అంటే మన సిలబస్కి సంబంధించి ఉన్నాయో వాటిని పోస్ట్ చేస్తాను. ఇవే కాకుండా రిఫరెన్స్ బుక్స్ నుంచి కూడా మీకు కొన్ని కొంత మెటీరియల్ పోస్ట్ చేస్తాను. ఓకే, సో ఇక ఓన్లీ ఇవే కాదు, మీకు ఏదైతే మనకి ఉన్నటువంటి సిలబస్లో ఉన్నటువంటి టెక్స్ట్ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో అందులో ముఖ్యంగా మన బీవీ రావు ఒక టెక్స్ట్ మనకు కనిపిస్తుంది వరల్డ్ హిస్టరీకి సంబంధించి. సో అది ఆన్లైన్ వర్క్ ఉన్నట్లు ఉన్నది పీడిఎఫ్ ఫార్మాట్లో. సో అది దొరికితే కూడా ఆ బుక్ మీకు నేను పోస్ట్ చేసే ప్రయత్నం చేస్తాను. అట్లనే మీకు నేను పోస్ట్ చేసినటువంటి ఏదైతే మెటీరియల్ ఉందో అది కొంతవరకు మీకు అసైన్మెంట్స్ రాయడానికి ఉపయోగపడుతుందని అనుకుంటున్నా. సో ఇంకా మనకి సిలబస్ అయ్యేంతలోపు మిగతా ఇంకా మెటీరియల్ ఎక్కువ మెటీరియల్ మీకు పోస్ట్ చేసే ప్రయత్నం మాత్రం చేస్తుంటాను. ఓకే, ఇంకేమైనా డౌట్స్ ఉన్నాయా? సో ఇక మీరు మళ్ళీ ఒకసారి చెప్తున్నాను, అసైన్మెంట్ ఏదైతే మీరు పేపర్ ఫోర్కు రాయాలి, ఎలా రాయాలి అంటే ఉన్నటువంటి ఫోర్ యూనిట్స్ నుంచి ఒక్కొక్క యూనిట్ నుంచి 2 ఎస్ఏ క్వశ్చన్స్ చూజ్ చేసుకోండి. ఓకే, అది మీ ఇష్టం. సో వాటికి ఎస్ఏ క్వశ్చన్స్కి ఆన్సర్స్ రాసి, అంటే 4 మాడ్యూల్ నుంచి 2 అంటే మొత్తం 8 ఎస్ఏ ఆన్సర్స్ రాసి పంపించాల్సి ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, ఇంకా చాలామంది అడుగుతున్నారు ఇంకా అసైన్మెంట్ ఏంటి సార్, ఏం చెప్పలేదు టాపిక్ అని. సో టాపిక్కి సంబంధించి ఏం లేదు, ఇక్కడ మాడ్యూల్ నుంచి ఒక్కొక్క ఎస్ఏ, సారీ 2 ఎస్ఏ క్వశ్చన్స్ మీరు చూజ్ చేసుకోవాలి. సో ఆ ఎస్ఏ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆన్సర్స్ రాసి అవి యాజ్ ఈజ్గా నాకు వాట్సాప్ చేస్తే సరిపోతుంది. ఓకే స్టూడెంట్స్, థ్యాంక్ యూ. రైట్, ఐఎమ్ ఎండింగ్ మై క్లాస్ నౌ.